For me, the reinvestigation was all about giving JonBenét a voice, because I feel very strongly that victims shouldn't become footnotes in their own murders. The victim's voice is never really heard unless you have an advocate, somebody who's prepared to stand up, to be bold, to be courageous on that person's behalf. In 2007, when I worked at the FBI in the behavioral units there, Quantico, I was very privileged to be able to review this case with a number of FBI profilers. So we're all here almost 20 years later. We're on a fact-finding mission. This is a reinvestigation, and of course we've got some of the best brains, not just in the US, in the world, around a table, trying to understand, you know, what went on in the house that night. And again, it just seems staggering, the facts and the evidence, the amount of available evidence, but yet I'll call it the BS of the last 20 years, because it's coming up for the anniversary, that has stolen the narrative. And I felt that it was very important to give her a voice when other voices have been heard. The first thing was actually rebuild the house. And, you know, that's no joke, recreating the Ramsey house. We certainly tried to get access to the house, but a lot of the layout had changed. So it made much more sense to actually recreate the house. Given that so much of the theories are speculative, we think it's so important to test out each hypothesis to establish whether it is even possible. You know, it wasn't just about going through the window, incidentally, which Lou Smith has done. And, you know, many people tweeted me about that, saying that Lou Smith has already gone through it. It was actually about the forensic transfer that took place.
How's your view from up there? How well can you see into this area?
So not particularly well. And if we also think that this was a wrought iron grate on top with some foliage as well, so you're not really going to get much of a vantage point to know what you're going into.
And you know what? This happened at night. So we're going to have to cut the lights to simulate that.
Right.
So everything down to the peanut butter marks on the walls to the cobwebs in the window that I destroyed going through.
So they'd have to lift up the wrought iron grate.
And lean it against the house.
Yep, so all the foliage would have been disturbed.
Right. How tight of a space is that there?
Well, coming into it, I mean, it feels pretty small. And of course, there's probably easier ways of getting in. So this doesn't open a huge amount.
Right.
It's a tricky entry point. But there is space.
All right, so it's possible.
To actually come through here, your body does have to come to this side because I don't have movement here. I mean, I can hold on to here, but I'm gonna have to drop my body through.
And in the crime scene video, when it's compared, you see the cobweb intact, which tells you no one went through that window. No one entered through that window, no one left through that window. Fact.